Hello again. So, back to our topic with Renaissance architecture. So, here's our timeline. From early Renaissance is 100 years, 1400 to 1500. Then, High Renaissance is a little shorter, for 25 years. Then, up to 1700 is the Mannerism. So, kumbaga, we'll take this as part of the High Renaissance but takes another stage. Then we have the Rococo and Baroque period at 1700 and 1800. So we'll discover why kung bakit may ganitong gap or ganitong short gap within High Renaissance but a larger ones with the early and the Mannerism part. So let's start with Renaissance in Italy. So it is also known as Quattrocento, and this is because of, or Quattrocento means 400, and this is because of the years belonging during this 14th to 15th century, or before, I mean, before 15th century, na yung 400 years na yun, kumbaga, meron tayong tinatawag or meron family during that time which are the Medici family, which are encouraging artists and creator to kumbaga to do commission works for them. So this family is very famous or kumbaga mayaman sila, very rich, and nagpapa-commission sila ng mga projects all over Italy. However, it is anonymous. So kumbaga, yung expense na yon is either from them or from people who are donating. Kumbaga, naging very successful or naging very progressive ang Italy during these periods because of this initiative. So, kaya kung mapapansin nyo, may kakaibang appreciation or kakaibang ways to make their design ang mga Italians. Basically, from Pisa Cathedral pa lang, meron na silang ibang approach. So, nandun yung classical detail and ornamentation with, kumbaga, may tinatawag tayong with arte. So, the design they do is, kumbaga, maarte sila sa design. And kumbaga kung anong na kung paano natin kumbaga kung may nerdy tayo na makakilala na sobrang geek sa isang technology, kumbaga sila yon yung version nun sa mga artist or nerdy yan, kumbaga art nerd sila, kaya sobrang way nila ng sobrang kakaiba yung way nila ng pag express sa art. And ayun nga, so with early Renaissance, there is organization, proportional logic, may rhythm, may geometries, and may reasoning, kumbaga sa bawat ano na to. And dito na rin unti-unti nagsisimula yung mga scholars na tinatawag, and these scholars are very smart sila. And inaaral na nila, aside from God, is the numbers. Kumbaga, nagkakaroon na sila ng iba-ibang idea from the meaning of life. Hindi lang siya sa about God, but about people as well. So, leaning towards community and society, kung kaya't na-introduce na yung mga different typologies dito, mayroon ng mga or ina-adapt na rin yung mga styles sa mga domestic buildings. So the prime example for this one is the Basilica di San Lorenzo in Florence by Filippo Brunelleschi during 1377 to 1446, which is which will be shown later. So, focus muna tayo. So, he is one of the foremost architects and engineers in Italy or Italian Renaissance. So, he is one of the early constructors, kumbaga. However, he is best known for his work at the Cathedral of Santa Maria del Fiore or the Domo. Basically, yung dome. And in Florence. However, the Domo or the term Domo is also coined as the whole structure as well as cathedral. So, meron konting kumbaga confusion dito sa mga terms na magagamit natin. So, let's focus first on him. So, he is kumbaga like a mason at traveler as well. So, kumbaga they go to different places in order to study or to learn more about different types of construction methods, innovations, materials, and also to kumbaga to promote their own and also to do commission works. So here's the Santa Maria del Fiore. And full part of it or yung walls niya is patterned, so with this materials. So kung mapapansin nyo, may signs siya ng Gothic elements with rose windows, three portals. But then, what gives it an additional Italian look is the cornices, the smaller details, yung dentils, then mostly horizontal looking rather than just being tall. But with this one, meron siyang sariling bell tower. So, this, kumbaga yung symmetry niya is nasa main. And, ayun. May separated na bell tower. So, yun yung mapapansin niyo sa ano, sa, kumbaga sa mga structures in Italy. Okay. Let me skip something. Sa structure na to, sa, ayan. I'm not able to see the San Lorenzo, but here, so same lang to, si Santa Maria del Fiore or Saint Mary of the Flower. Ang isa sa main na na-introduce niya is this dome. So, way of constructing a dome. So, during that time, yun nga, may sinasabi silang, kumbaga, commission work, especially for a dome. Then, they want to make a different kind of way of constructing the dome. And the story is, during these times, nag-travel si Brunelleschi sa parts of Greece. And nag-study siya ng mga iba-ibang domes sa mga Greek structure. So, kumbaga meron pa rin nun. Meron nang na-introduce nun. And roofings. So, syempre, yung sa kanila nun, hindi pa ganun ka ano, ka perfect, ka structurally sound, or, I mean, structurally sound sila pala, pero they're massive. So, they're not kumbaga may risk dahil mabigat na yung shell and mabigat yung material itself. So, may danger, kumbaga. And he's aiming to make it or to turn it in a different one. Tapos, yung commission work na to is kumbaga maraming nag-try. However, hindi nila alam kung paano execute. So here are the comparisons. We have the Pantheon and the Istanbul as well. So aside from the Greek temples, ito din pinuntahan niya. So kung mapapansin nyo, with this, meron ng covered ceiling sa Pantheon. Then with Hagia Sophia in Istanbul, kumbaga manipis yung material from inside. It has some grooves or some kung sa ano to, kumbaga meron siyang structural support na going towards the center. Ganun din dito with covered ceiling. So, dun na i-adapt. And what he did is he used an egg to elaborate the or his theory even more. However, hindi niya agad to na-execute. Kumbaga, pinakita niya muna doon sa family na nagpapa-commission in order to prove it. And as well as nung siya rin ang nag-start, nung in-accept na yung project, he is also in doubt. But then, he studied very well. He made dahil magaling siya sa math. Kumbaga, alam mo yung tipong you see something na you see a structure and you're able to discern kung paano yung kumbaga paano yung skeleton niya or how it stands or it supports it, how it is supported, kung paano siya na-build, or idea of innovations. So kumbaga may ganun siyang talent, and that time syempre hindi biro yung ano yung ma-idea ka sa mga ganun. So doon nag-start yung contractual work niya with the dome. And ang ano na yon, ang dome nito is inspired by that. So meron siyang horizontal courses na tinatawag. This is seen at the Pantheon. Then kumbaga meron na tayong tinatawag na ano dito, na structural frame with shell, kumbaga with building shell. So with this, meron siyang main structural forms sa pagitan, then merong walls both interior and exterior. Kasi ang dating ginagawa nila, since stone siya, so rekta, siya na yung mismong finish, siya pa yung structural. Pero dito, nag-iba. So, they used oak timbers para sa structural support. Then, they made it, ginawa nilang medyo pointy yung profile niya, parang egg, in order to exert less thrust. Kasi, kapag mas flat, kumbaga ito, dahil kung gagawin mo mas flat, matitibag yung dito sa taas. So yan, unlike dito, sinusupport niya upward to, less force, kumbaga mas balance yung dito. Itong span na ng rib na to or ng upward support na yan, nagbibigay na siya ng enough structural strength para maging balance yung buong dome along with its yun nga, yung lantern niya. So here's a section of it. So nandun pa rin yung mga typical parts. We have the oculus, we have the lantern, we have our tower, and itong ang main dome na to with two finishes. And yung finish na ginawa nila is, or yung pattern na ginawa nila in brickwork, is what we call the herringbone. So perpendicularly ano sila, late. So kumbaga nagkaroon ng salabungan at a certain portion in order to give a different kind of support. So ito, parang nakalock sila sa bawat portions ng perpendicular laid na bricks. So here's a view from inside. So during this time, so sa Italy, maraming artists, sobrang daming sikat na artists na introduce. And per areas of work, naalala niyo yung sinabi ko last time na, kumbaga, contractual works. So, each face of the wall has paintings, and aside from that, ito nga, ceiling. Ceiling is one of their main canvas. So, makakita kayo ng mga paintings within that. So, aside from that, ito yung mga ibang projects ni Brunelleschi. So, this is Hospital of the Innocent. Hospital degli Innocenti. Or, ito. Okay. Then, the next one is the Founding Hospital. So, kung mapapansin nyo, yung way of proportions niya para sa mga columns and pilasters is different na. More slender, tamang scale, yun na, going to human proportions, daily lives, kumbaga. Then, we have this Church of San Lorenzo, which has rusticated walls. Here's the interior. So, ang laki ng difference, pero yan, ganyan ang ano nila. So, we don't have the arc ceiling here, but ito na. Ni-introduce na rin yung mga flat kumbaga flat ceiling with this covered patterns. Then the Church of Santo Espirito, that is very plain. However, sa interior sila, or sa interior mo mas mapapansin yun sa ano na to, sa design niya. So, covered ceilings. Next, we have Leon Battista Alberti. So, he is what we know called the linear perspective, or he provided the theory, I mean, of linear perspective. So, we'll tackle about kung sino yung gumawa ng linear and perspective. However, yun, he's one of the writers na nag-add ng learnings doon. So, aside from architecture, people here are starting to have multiple careers or use their talents in different ways. So, kumbaga, Renaissance is also like reviving the reviving the classics. Yun nga. Kaya nandun yung, may kita nyo yung elements of Greek and Roman architecture. So, mostly gamit yung mga capitals, yung mga yung roofing nila with then with pediment, yung mga cornices, yung mga dentils, yung mga patterns. So, Renaissance is using those, or kaya nga again and be born again, parang ganun. Utilizing those old classical design elements and turning it into that modern during that time, the modern of that time, which is Renaissance. And yun nga, very inspired sila sa mga ways nila nun. So, kumbaga, na-discovered nila yung pattern, yung mga numbers, equations nila, inaral nila na mabuti how it evolved, kumbaga yung hindi nila naiintindihan during the Romanesque and Gothic architecture. Ito yun. Natuto sila dito and they want to create meaning with it. They want to not just be controlled sa kung ano lang yung dapat pinapaalam sa kanila, but yun nga, nagkakaroon ng mga scholars, mga tao na meron sarili ng ways of teaching. So, his projects are this, one is baptistry of San Giovanni. So ayun, again, extruded patterns with the post and lintel, some arcs that are kumbaga Roman arcs tinatawag. Then at yung stone na to, kung naalala niyo yung isang church sa Gothic period. But then, yun nga, interior. So, mas ano sila sa interior with this. So, yung paintings and other details sa wall. So, yun. Both of these are part of the structure. Nakahiwalay na bell tower. Nakahiwalay na ano, baptistry. Then, yung mismong cathedral. So, yun. Kung mapapansin nyo yun, no? Mga similarities nila. And, yung similarity nito, mapapansin nyo dahil naging magkasama si, ano, si Alberti tsaka si Brunelleschi sa mga ginagawa. Kaya, influence sila sa way of art ng bawat isa. Yung parang may outline yung bawat design elements and way of proportioning. So, slender na rin yung mga columns, like that. Then, yun, yung patterns, spaces. Then, another one is the San Andrea, Church of San Andrea. Very simple, but has that look, that appeal na ano na siya. So, yun, mapapansin nyo yung pediment. Then, Palazzo Rucelli. Usually, yun nga, symmetrical siya, so may kasunod pa dito. Kumbaga, meron lang silang spacing and pattern kung saan ilalagay yung doors, but then, both ends of it are similar. Kung tatlo man to, tamang span or ng per section ng bawat roofing. So, next is the High Renaissance. 25-year period, and it is derived from the classical antiquity. So, kumbaga, yun nga, nandun pa rin yung, evident pa rin yung mga, ano, yung mga Greek and Roman features, but then, mas naging decorated and ornamental yung mga parts ng mga structure during this time. So, one of the famous architect that is introduced during this time is Bramante. And yun, said to be or said to expand the applicability of classical architecture to contemporary buildings. So Bramante is an architect from Milan, and kumbaga influence this style of Renaissance to Rome. So he is one of the first great Renaissance architect, and one of his work is St. Peter's and Vatican and this large complex of structure. So St. Peter's Basilica will be discussed later. So si Bramante is one of the most significant architects, and ayun, aside from this, during this time, ang mga structures is parang pinapasa ang way of designing. Or, pinapasa yung lead architect. Kumbaga may lead architect, then napapasa into different architects, depende sa portions. So, his works are usually like this. Kumbaga sa exterior, merong parang outlines ang windows, but then, and openings, but then, ang brickwork is the typical one, but obvious. Pagdating naman sa interior, it's, kumbaga, kung may covered ceiling tayo, diba? With this, in-integrate nila yung portions na yun sa bawat arcs in order to give design. He's still using the traditional ones with vaulting with quadripartite vaulting, but then paintings on the walls were evident and patterns in the ceiling are evident. So, hindi na siya yung typical design na nakikita natin. Kumbaga, yun, dun sila mas naging creative. So, imagine how they sculpted, how they painted each portion, and how they made sure na magiging very well detailed may story na kinukwento. So each part, ayan, basically canvas nila lahat ng portions ng ano structure. So Bramante is one of them. Then the Last Supper. So si Last Supper is by Leonardo da Vinci, and Leonardo maybe correct me if I'm wrong or search about it better. So si Bramante ang nag-start ng perspective, but then Leonardo da Vinci linear perspective. But then Leonardo da Vinci developed the one-point perspective, which is seen here. And si Leonardo da Vinci has a different way of ano, diba, of painting, has a different appeal. It ayan. We will study about it in the further, pero take note or observe niyo yung mga paintings niya na nasa presentation. Next, we have the St. Peter's Basilica. This is the largest church complex in the whole world. And, ayun, maraming architects ang na-introduce dito. So, we'll end our presentation here for a while. We'll talk about St. Peter's Basilica and some specifics on the next presentation.